Hi
guys, this is Shivansh Goel from LEXIS AND COMPANY, and today I am to discuss about Hindu Maintenance Act. So first of all, we must need to understand which persons are liable to get maintenance under the Hindu Maintenance Act.
First
of all, the wife, then the widow, then parents and children, whether legitimate or illegitimate, then comes the dependents. So first of all, let's discuss about the maintenance of wife. So maintenance of wife is basically defined under section 18 of the Hindu. All his family members are harassing her so that she can get more and more dowry from them. If the husband is having with any other wife, if the husband is suffering from apathy, or if she is having separately from her husband because of his rude behavior, as he continuously beats his wife. So under these cases, husband is liable to give maintenance to his wife. Then comes section 19, which is maintenance of widow. The wife of the deceased husband will be liable to get maintenance from the husband's family or from her own father and mother, and no one can stop her from claiming maintenance. Then comes section 20, which is maintenance of children and the aged parents. If the aged parents are not able to maintain themselves, then under that case, husband will be liable to give maintenance to his aged parents. Same is the case with the illegitimate children. Suppose if the child is minor who is under the age of 16 years, then under that case, husband would be liable to give maintenance to the children also. Then comes section 21, which basically tells us about the dependents who can take maintenance. As I have discussed before also, the wife, widow, and the aged parents and children and the dependents also. So these are the people who can claim maintenance under the Hindu Maintenance Act. Then comes dependents. Then comes section 22, which tells about the maintenance. Here they would also get maintenance from the legal heirs of their family, or it can be given either through accession, where the property would be equally divided into the heirs of the family. So this is how dependence can be maintained, and the amount of maintenance will be SID by the court, and it is the court's discretionary power, and the maintenance will be SID depending upon the reputation of the party, and it will also depend upon the income of the husband also. So this was all about in the maintenance in a short term, and also maintenance should be claimed only by a Hindu also, and if husband has changed his religion from Hindu to either Muslim, Parsi, then under that is also he would be liable to give maintenance. So this was all about the summary of the Hindu Maintenance Act, and if you are in love, then you can ask.